Welcome to Gentle Yoga. My name is Liza and thank you for joining me. So tonight I'm going to offer a gentle practice to help you to unwind and let go of your day and prepare to transition for a restful evening. So we will begin in a standing position. So make your way to stand on your yoga mat. To stand nice and tall, relaxing the shoulders, lengthening through the spine, and lifting the crown of the head towards the sky. Allow your eyes to close or gaze very softly down towards the floor. And just take a moment here to connect to your feet. You feel the contact of your feet to the mat and to the earth beneath you. Allow yourself to feel grounded and settled. Now begin to shift the weight from the balls to the foot of the feet, lifting the heels, and then lifting the toes away from the floor as you shift your weight onto the balls of the feet. Just shifting forward and back. Beginning to give a little stretch to the calves and to the feet. And just playing with that connection to the earth beneath you. Now allow the feet to settle. Fingertips reaching down towards the earth as you relax the shoulders, inviting the breath to flow in and out through the nose. And we'll begin to coordinate the breath with movement. So reaching long through the fingertips. And as you inhale, reach the arms out to the side and overhead. And then as you exhale, turn the palms to face you as you slowly lower the arms down in front. And we'll do this a few times at your own pace. So beginning on your next inhalation, arms lift up to the side and overhead. And as you're ready to exhale, turn the palms to face the body as you lower the arms down. And bring the head and neck into the movement. As you inhale, lifting the arms overhead, lifting the chin. The soft gaze upward, if you like. And then exhale, lowering the chin towards the chest as you release the arms down. Now we'll expand on this movement. So as you exhale and lower the arms down, bend into the knees, moving into a squat, and then inhaling, lifting the arms up as you straighten the legs, tilting the chin upward. And exhale, lowering the arms, bending the knees into the squat, beginning to warm up the thighs and the legs. And once more. And completing with the arms overhead, standing tall, relax the shoulders. Bring the palms together to touch. And as you exhale, slowly lower the arms down, bring the hands to prayer position in front of the heart. Close the eyes if you like and pause here to feel the heartbeat. Noticing any sensations of warmth or energy from the movements you've done so far. Pause here to check in and notice how you are feeling. And seeing how you are feeling in this moment as a result of whatever you've done today. Perhaps you had a busy day, maybe a stressful day. And see if you could just let go of your day, bringing yourself into this very present moment. And setting an intention on how you would like to feel after completing your yoga class. feeling more calm, feeling more focused, more relaxed, perhaps feeling more accepting of yourself. Just taking a moment to think about how it is that you would like to feel and set an intention for yourself, knowing that your practice will give you just what you need. And now releasing the arms by your sides, and give a little shake to one leg and then the other. We'll bring the feet a little bit wider than hips width apart, bringing the hands to the hips and giving a little bend to the knees, and begin to circle the hips. Keep breathing naturally in and out through the nose. And if you'd like, you might want to start off with small circles, and then perhaps gradually making the circles larger. Just allow your body to guide you. So would it feel better to move slower or faster? See what works for you in this moment. And now pause here to reverse and begin to move your circles in the opposite direction. And we'll begin to make those circles a little bit smaller, a little bit slower, and very gradually finding your way back to stillness. Bringing the feet underneath the hips, standing tall, and then bringing your attention to the shoulders. And as you inhale, draw the shoulders up towards your ears, and then exhale, rolling the shoulders back and down. Easing away any tension or tightness that you may be holding in the upper back and shoulders, and just allowing that tension to release and let go. Reminding yourself to continue to take care of yourself throughout the class. So if anything I'm leading doesn't feel quite right, you could feel free to take a break or modify in a way that works for you. And rolling the shoulders once more and letting that go. Take a deep breath in and out. And as you next inhale, bring the arms out to the side and overhead. Shoulder width apart, fingertips reaching up towards the sky. We'll do some side stretches here too. Lengthen through the spine and loosen up the sides of the body. So as you inhale, reach one arm overhead, bending into that same knee. And exhale, releasing and moving to the other side. You can imagine that you're reaching up to the sky. Lengthening through one side of the body and then the other. And reaching once more to each side. And coming to center. Take a deep breath in through the nose. And as you exhale, slowly lowering your arms down. Allow the arms to relax and soften. Notice how you feel. And next we'll move into a half sun salutation. So again, you're like rounding into the feet, standing tall, lengthening through the spine, relaxing the shoulders. As you next inhale, bring the arms out to the side and overhead, bringing the palms together to touch, feel like gazing upward. And then as you exhale, extend the arms to T position at shoulder height. As you hinge forward from the hips, giving a little bit of a bend to the knees as you soften into a forward fold. And now on your next inhalation, either bring the fingertips to the floor or bring the hands to the shins. As you inhale and lengthen through the spine, lifting just halfway. And then exhale, soften into the fold, release the crown of the head. And now press into the feet. Bring the hands to the hips, pull the navel towards the spine, and inhale as you lift with a long neutral spine, slowly making your way back up to standing. Bringing the arms out to the sides and overhead. And then exhale, lower the hands to the heart, completing one round of half sun salutation. And we'll repeat this again. Inhale, arms reach out to the side and overhead.
Then exhale, hinging from the hips, bringing the arms into T position. Soften into the forward fold. And you can bend the knees a little or a lot. Do that to the crown of the head. And then let a little bit of shape to release. And either coming on the fingertips or bringing the hands to the shins. Lift halfway, lengthen through the spine. Exhale, fold forward. Hands to hips, navel to spine. Inhale as you slowly lift up to standing. Bringing the arms out to the side and overhead. And exhale, lower the hands to prayer position in front of the heart. Pause here for a breath to check in, receive, noticing how you're feeling. And then we will add on. So coming to the front of your yoga mat. Relax the shoulders, release the arms. Inhaling, bringing the arms out to the side and overhead. Exhaling, hinge forward into the forward fold. Relax the head and neck. Inhaling, lift halfway, lengthen. Now as you exhale, lower the fingertips to the floor, bending the knees as much as you need to. And then step the right foot back, lowering that knee to the floor and coming into a lunge. So the front knee is in line with the ankle, and you can rest on the fingertips on your palms. And then we'll loosen up the thighs and warm up the legs here. So on your next inhalation, straighten the front leg a little or a lot and keep your toes away from the floor. And then exhale, lengthen the back. Again, inhaling, straighten the leg, and then exhaling again. Continue to move back and forth at your own pace with the breath. Just notice the sensation in the hip and the leg. And now the next time that you bend the knee, coming into your low lunge and holding here. Now prepare to lift the torso. So as you next inhale, bring one hand at a time to the front knee, lifting the torso upright. And bringing the hands to the hips. And draw the tailbone down as you lengthen evenly through the abdomen and the lower back. Broadening through the chest and relaxing the shoulders. And you can keep the hands here on the hips. Or if you like, releasing the arms. And then inhaling, bringing the arms up and overhead so that the arms are shoulder width apart. Keep breathing deeply in and out through the nose. And if the mind becomes distracted here, see if you can return your attention to the breath and the sensations that you're feeling in this moment. One more breath here, and then exhaling, lowering the arms down. We'll come into a variation here, adding a spinal twist. So bringing the right hand to the floor, opposite hand comes to the hip, and twist in the direction of your front bent knee. And options here are to keep the hand on the lower back for a little more support. If you'd like, you can extend that arm straight up from the shoulder. Again, make any adjustments here. You feel more at ease. See where you could send your breath to soften and relax as you pull the pose. One more full breath here. And then exhaling, slowly unwinding, lowering that hand to the floor. And now step that front knee back, coming into a table position, coming onto the hands and knees. Wrists underneath the shoulders, fingers spread wide. Knees are below the hips. And lengthen through your spine by extending the tailbone and the crown of the head away from one another. Broadening through the chest and moving the shoulder blades down the back. On your next inhalation, lift the tailbone, arching and gazing upward. And then as you exhale, draw the tailbone tailbone under, rounding the spine, moving the chin in towards the chest. Moving back and forth at the pace of your own breath. Inhaling as you arch into dog, and exhaling as you round into cat. Just move the sensations along the spine as you stretch and move. And moving once more in each direction. And reaching into a neutral spine. And now we'll prepare for the opposite leg. So now stepping your right foot forward, bringing the knee in line with the ankle. Feels like you can slide the back knee a little closer to the rear of the mat, lifting the chest and relaxing the shoulders. And now we'll bend and straighten this front leg. So inhale, lifting the toes as you straighten that leg a little more lat. Start off with smaller movements, and then if you like, gradually making the movements a little bit larger. And the next time that you bend the knee, holding in the lunge position. As your next inhale, bring one hand at a time to the front knee, lifting the torso. And draw the tailbone down as you lengthen through the abdomen and the lower back. Relax the shoulders, bringing the hands to the hips. Gazing straight ahead, bringing your chin parallel to the earth. Breathing naturally in and out through your nose. You could stay here, or if you like, you could bring the arms overhead. If you'd like, you could try bringing the arms a little bit wider apart to see how that feels. You can try flexing through the hands and pressing the fingertips back to give a stretch to the wrists, forearms, hands, and fingers. So that can feel good if you've been spending time on the keyboard or other electronic devices to get the wrists a little released. One more full breath here, and then exhaling slowly, lowering the arms down, bringing the fingertips or palms to the mat, and preparing for the twist on the side. So now planting the left hand onto the floor, right hand comes to the right hip, and twisting in the direction of the front of the knee. So being careful here not to force or strain, but only come to a comfortable place in the twist where you feel a good sensation. You can keep the hand on the lower back, or if you like, extending the arm overhead. And feel free to make any adjustments here to create a little bit more ease and comfort. And on the next exhalation, very slowly unwinding, coming back to the lunge. And from here, we'll prepare to step forward. So bringing the ball of the back foot to the floor, straightening that leg into a high lunge, and then stepping the back foot forward, coming into the forward fold, relax the crown of the head. And then keep the head on the head in like a gentle shape. Now open the mouth and keep the jaw a little wiggle from side to side to release any tension in the jaw and the face. On your next inhalation, lift halfway. And then exhale, soften and fold forward. Bring the hands to the hips. Press into the feet, navel to spine. Inhale as you slowly lift all the way to standing. Bringing the arms out to the side and then overhead. Palms touch. And then exhaling, lower the hands to prayer position in front of the heart. allow the eyes to close or soften the gaze. And take a moment here to check in. Noticing how you're feeling right now in the body, mind, and breath. And turning your awareness to the intention that you set at the start of your practice. And gradually release the arms, give a little shift to one leg and then the other. We'll move through another half sun salutation and we'll make our way towards the floor. So standing tall, relaxing the shoulders, feet are right underneath the hips. Inhaling, bring the arms out to the side and then overhead. Bring the palms together to touch. And then exhaling, hinge forward, coming into your forward fold. Bend the knees a little or a lot here. Then inhaling, hold it. Way, lengthening through your spine. Exhale, soften forward. Now bending one knee and then the other, lowering down into a table position once again. And from table, we'll release into a puppy stretch. Keeping the hips lifted above the knees, slide the arms forward and lower either the forehead or chest to the mat, or you can allow the head to hover away from the floor. So you can experiment and see what feels best for you. Continue to breathe deeply. Making any adjustments to create the most comfort. Always welcome to hold the pose a little bit longer or release a little bit sooner if that's what you prefer. And now a release. If you haven't already, on your next inhalation, lifting the torso, coming back into a table position. And from table, swinging the legs around and coming into a seated position. Sitting tall with the hands underneath the shoulders, extending the legs. And begin to flex and point the feet. Giving a little stretch here to the calves as you release the ankles. Now bring the feet a little wider apart and begin to circle the feet, drawing the big toes towards one another and then away. And pause here and then circle in the opposite direction. And give the legs a little shake from side to side. Allowing the legs and feet to soften here and relax after all the work they've done today. We often take the feet and legs for granted, so it's nice to give them a little bit of attention. Now shifting on into a seated position with the knees bent and the feet on the floor. And from here, we'll prepare to make our way onto our backs. So bringing the hands underneath the shoulders and slowly and gently rolling onto your back with the hands resting by your sides. And keeping the feet and knees hip-width apart. And just take a few breaths here to allow yourself to adjust to lying on your back. Bring your attention now to the parts of your body that are in contact with the floor. Let's see if you could receive that grounding energy from the earth, feeling that sense of stability. And bringing a little bit more of the upper back and shoulders in contact with the floor, creating a sense of spaciousness in the chest and the torso. And tuck the chin very slightly, keeping the back of the neck long. And we'll loosen up the spine a little bit more here, and then we'll ease into a bridge posture. Pressing the feet into the mat. And as you next inhale, lifting the hips an inch or so away from the mat, and then exhaling, lowering the hips back down. And again, inhaling as you lift. And exhaling, lower down. Continuing to lift and lower at your own pace. It feels like if you try lifting the hips a little bit higher each time. Giving a little bit more flexibility in the spine here. And you could stay here with the lifting and lowering, or if you'd like, you could come to hold the bridge posture. Looking the hips so that they're in line with the shoulders and the knees to begin. Walking the feet in a little bit closer to the bottom. And you could check in here to see how this feels. If you're feeling any signs of strain, you could slowly release the pose, or you could just try backing off and lowering the hips a little closer to the earth. If you're feeling spacious and open, you could try lifting the hips a little bit higher. So you can experiment with lifting and lowering the hips until you find the place that feels just right for you. Avoiding any strain or discomfort, but finding that comfortable stretch that feels just right. So hold bridge pose here for a few more breaths, and if you need to release sooner, that's always fine. You might want to keep the hands resting by your sides. So if you're feeling limber, you could clasp the hands together beneath you, wiggling one shoulder blade at a time beneath you. Create a little bit more openness in the spine. So you can play with that. If it doesn't feel good, it's fine to keep the hands resting by your sides. Allowing the belly to soften as you inhale, allowing that belly to expand. And as you exhale, emptying and releasing the breath completely. A few more deep breaths here. And holding for one more full breath, and then we'll prepare to gradually release. Now we pass the hands together. Release the hands and gently return one shoulder blade at a time to the mat. And then as you exhale, moving very slowly, returning first through the upper and middle back. And taking your time as you gradually lower the hips back to the floor. And after you release, bring the knees together to touch, sliding the feet a little further away so that the legs could soften and relax. And just noticing the sensation of release. And allowing yourself to receive the energetic imprint of bridge posture. Noticing what you are feeling as a result of this pose. Noticing where in your body you may feel sensations such as warmth, aliveness. Notice where you may feel stretched or strengthened. Allow yourself to experience all the sensations that are here for you. Well, release the spine by moving into a windshield wiper. So bring the feet about as wide apart as your mat. And you can extend the arms to T position, shoulder height, or you can bend the arms at the elbows. And now begin to drop the knees from side to side. You could start off keeping the movement small and perhaps gradually making the movement larger. Breathing here as you drop the knees from side to side, and perhaps both knees will make it down to the floor. And again, finding your own pace here, moving slower or quicker as you prefer. Now dropping the knees once more to each side. And then returning to center. And extending the legs straight along the floor. And reaching the arms overhead along the floor. And as your next inhale, reach long through the fingertips. Press out through the soles of the feet. And feel the whole body growing longer. And then exhale, soften. Again, inhaling, lengthening, reaching up through the fingertips, up through the soles of the feet. And then exhaling, relax and release down. And we're bringing the arms to T position at shoulder height. We'll prepare to move into a spinal twist here. So just bringing a little bit more of the upper back and shoulders into the floor. Relaxing the body into the mat. And now bending the right knee and placing the right foot above the opposite thigh. Knees pointing upward. And now lengthen through your spine as you inhale. And then as you exhale, begin to draw the right knee across the body as you shift your weight onto the left hip. With the left hand gently guiding the knee a little bit closer towards the earth. Be careful to avoid any strain here, just moving slowly, working with your breath. And you could keep the head still facing upward, or if you like, you could turn the head away from the knee, looking over the right shoulder. See what's best for you. Keeping the upper back and both shoulders connected to the mat. Keeping your breath flowing in and out through the nose. And if you like, softening that knee a little bit closer to the floor as you exhale. Closing the eyes or gazing softly. Allow yourself to explore any little adjustments. Moving any way to make the posture feel most relaxing for you. Welcome to move a little bit deeper, back off, or slowly release the pose if that's what you need. And if you'd like, you could move a little bit deeper into your fullest expression for another breath. And then on your next inhalation, very slowly releasing, gently guiding the knee back to center. Taking your time, noticing those sensations as you release. And bringing the hips back in line with the spine in the shoulders. Lifting both knees, bringing the feet to the floor, bringing the knees together to touch. And noticing here how one side of the body feels in comparison to the other. And now prepare to balance it out. So now straightening the right leg along the floor, flexing through that foot, bringing the arms to T position. And now bringing the left foot above the right thigh, knees facing upward. And now bring that right hand to the left knee. And then as you exhale, begin to draw that knee across the body, shifting your weight onto the right hip. And taking your time here. Both shoulders connected to the floor. On each exhalation, you can try drawing the knee slightly closer to the floor and being careful to avoid any strain or discomfort. Could turn the head to look towards the left hand, or you could keep the head in a neutral position and gazing upward. Feel free here to shift and adjust, making micro movements to create more ease. Like moving to your fullest expression for another breath. And then on your next inhalation, very slowly and gradually unwinding from the pose, slowly making your way onto your back. You may feel like your hips are sliding over to one side of the mat. So bending the knees, bringing the feet to the floor, bringing the hips back in line with the spine, bringing the knees together to touch, relaxing the arms by your sides with the palms facing upward. Notice these sensations in the spine, the hips, receiving the effects of the now draw one knee at a time in towards the chest. And you have some options here. So you can hold onto the knees or the shins, drawing the knees in towards your chest. Or if you like, you could come into happy baby. So see what feels better. So for happy baby, bending the knees towards the chest as the bottoms of the feet lift up towards the sky. And you could take hold of calves, the ankles, the toes, wherever you could comfortably reach. Drawing the knees in a little bit closer towards you. And whether you're holding the knees in towards the chest or coming into a happy baby, you could hold here in stillness, or you could play with the posture. You could try rocking a little bit from side to side. If you're holding knees into the chest, you can try circling on the sacrum. Just feel free to play and explore here with any variations that would feel good. And very gradually returning to stillness. hold of the feet, relaxing the legs down, gradually returning the feet to the floor. And then we'll come into a brief relaxation here, straightening the legs along the floor, relaxing the arms by your sides with the palms facing upward. Allow the eyes to close if they aren't already. Bring your attention to the parts of your body that are in contact with the earth. Receiving support and stability from the earth. Allow your body to soften and relax and release. Begin to scan the body, noticing what has changed for you since the start of your practice. Allow yourself to notice whatever it is you are feeling. Whatever you are feeling without any judgment. Observing with compassion and curiosity. Very gently allow the feet and toes to wiggle, wiggling the fingers. And now bending one knee at a time, drawing the knees in towards the chest, giving the knees a little gentle squeeze. And slowly rolling over onto your right side, coming into a fetal position. And pausing here on your side, taking a moment to acknowledge your efforts and your dedication. And very gently and slowly pressing the hands into the floor, make your way into a seated position. Sitting tall, relaxing the shoulders, bringing the hands to prayer position in front of the heart and allowing the eyes to close. Taking a moment here to reflect on something you've cultivated in your practice that you can take with you into the rest of your evening. Om Shanti Peace. May the peace in our hearts bring peace into the world. Very softly allow the eyes to open, lifting the gaze. Namaste. We are the light in you.